kolej o 4.00 z amsterdamskim na Zaukrycaj. Započnemo s ukrcaj prioritetnih putnika, dobacavamo putnike poznane klase, komorske na turista na ESCO putnike, za prvi pristup i izlazu.
Rada, ali bez slušalica tijekom uputa za slučaj opasnosti. Ladies and gentlemen, we have just landed at Amsterdam Airport.
Jutro, evo nakon 3 sata vožnje uspio sam nekako stići u Amsterdam, čak je bilo upitno hoću uopće moći u grad. Iz airporta do centra vi možete doći za onak 10 do 20 minuta vlakom, tako da nema smisla da ne odem do centra kada već imam layover od 10 sati. Otišao sam si prvo po kavu da ne bi slučajno bez svoje kave započeo dan. Nije me niko ništa pita za koronu, niti ništa. Šta idem sad uzeti ne za jest, jer sam nevjerojatno gladan. Na Kroaciju opet nisu dali ni za jest. I idem razgledat malo Amsterdam. Idem na neki trip tu besplatan po Amsterdamu. To funkcionira na foru da imate kao besplatan trip i onda na kraju te ture, gdje vas kao vodič odvede, imate mogućnost čovjeku, ne znam, dat napojnicu ili nešto tak. I na kraju su takve ture, bar meni osobno, puno bolje, jer se vodič više potrudi oko cijele stvari. Dobijete neke informacije koje će vam dati neko ko živi ovdje.
I mean, here, I'll give you an example of my dad's boyfriend, like, this first guy I dated. I took him out for his birthday, like, 2 months, his birthday is 2 months ahead of mine, I took him out for his birthday. He's a Dutch man, so what did he want to do on his birthday? He wanted to go eat pancakes, very Dutch. Took him out for pancake dinner, I bought it, I said, honey, it's on me, boom. 2 months later, it's my birthday, he goes, honey, I'll buy the wine. My face made a face that was like, what? He goes, well, you have to understand, in this country, technically, on your birthday, you pay. So I'm like, okay, I get it, but on your birthday, I bought you dinner. He goes, I just thought that was a cultural tradition in your country.
Full imaju liberalne sve zakone i puno je drugačije. A i to je narod koji se onako dosta vozi biciklima, nekako smanjuju aute na minimum.
Yeah, we are obviously built on an unstable foundation. That's why some of these bridges and canal walls are collapsing. A lot of what was built in Amsterdam was built in the 16th, 17th century. They still do, but they have to drive pylons 20 meters straight down to build a foundation, which to build the homes. And since they're made from wood historically, they start to rot. Enough of them rot, that's when your house kind of tilts to the side, your windows break, your floors are uneven. And fixing the foundation can be costly. And Dutch people are kind of known for being tight with money. You ever heard that expression, going Dutch? Even some people are like, you'll see it in the Facebook forums, like, I want to buy a house, can I do it on my own? And everyone's like, yeah, sure, like, you can probably close the deal on your own, but you want to make sure you have a top-notch foundation inspector. Because you don't want to get in there and find out you got to fix the foundation, because it is expensive. So an average home will sell for about 11,000 per square meter in the city. And if you see anything cheaper, like by a lot especially, it's usually an indication the foundation's broke.
Very good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome on board of this KLM City Upper flight with destination Valencia. A very warm welcome for our flying crew and SkyTeam members. In a few moments, we will start with our flight safety procedures on board of this aircraft. All instructions will be given in English only. If you have any questions, then please don't hesitate to ask.
Send help, I'm trapped in Amsterdam. No.